But you think about their season so far, this up to this point, beating St. Mary's and San Diego State, they are really difficult to guard because they have so many three-point shooters on the floor at all times. So a lot of times five, and most of the night four. So, you know, they just lit us up in the first half, and our defense, we couldn't rebound it, we couldn't stop them, and everything changed in the second half. You know, we guarded better. We Evan Gilliard, you know, I told him, I don't even know if he had a basket. He made some free throws, but the job that he had, one basket, you know, 0-for-4 from three, but Tim, the job that he did on Flynn was tremendous. I thought Jake Flagger's job, Jake doesn't score. I tell our guy, you don't have to score to impact winning, and that's proof with Evan Gilliard and Jake. But obviously we got some good offense from Keith and Omega again. I'm glad to see Omega play well, and having Matt back was tremendous down the stretch going to rebound it.
It's easy to say your guards played well, but your guards played winning basketball. I felt it a lot of times, especially early on when you guys were kind of on the ropes a little bit and they were up 30-something, some that had like 10-point lead. But some of your guards just made winning plays tonight.
It is. You know, we had, they went to 3-1 in the last 8 minutes or so. And we worked on it all week. It didn't look like it, but it was just kind of Evan Gilliard. And we told, if it gets late clock, drive it, man, and see if you can get fouled. He did, and he drove those free throws. But you're right, guard play, poise, making the right play. I thought for a freshman, dude, was tremendous tonight. Again, he wasn't great scoring-wise, but made his free throws, but he defended. But having Omega and Keith out there as weapons of scoring, you know, but and having Matt back, so obviously a huge factor. And he's not ready. He's not ready to play at full strength, but he rebounded. His length was a factor, but you could tell offensively with his hand, wasn't handling the ball particularly well.
Coach, I guess when Keith plays with a lot of energy, you guys are a little bit different team.
Yeah, Keith, we got to get Keith, complete, make him a complete player because we obviously know he can shoot it and score, and he's learning. He's getting better defensively and just passing and understanding the score and time and all those things, but we gave him player of the game, I thought, just because, not just his scoring, but you look up the stat, he's our leading rebounder. And so, for him to do that as a 6'4", two guard was huge.
First half, I thought you guys played great defense. They just crushed you on the boards.
Yeah.
What changed in the second half?
Well, Matt Wilm decided to go rebound. We just talked, you know, listen, they're scoring off of putbacks and loose balls, just grabbing loose balls, laying it up. If we could rebound a ball and hold them one shot, we thought, you know, the numbers would go down. We could guard them better, and it did. And we still rebounded the ball better. We guarded better. But we limited them to one shot for the most part in the second half. I mean, 42 in the first and 27 in the second, so it got a lot better.
Coach, when's the last time you remember beating a Pac-12 team, and how does this one compare?
Well, let's see. We beat Washington State a couple of years ago up there. I don't recall. This has been a four-year deal. I think we're 3-1 against them, but I'm not sure. But I think that was the last win against the Pac-12. We went to Oregon a few years ago and played them down to the wire, you know, at Oregon. So it's a good win for the program, a good win for a guy. He just develops a little more belief system. It gives him encouragement to come to practice and get better.
Crowd. How's the crowd?
Oh, man. I'm glad you brought that up. I want to thank everybody that came out. You know, given the circumstances are unique, and I get that. But to come out and support these kids and the team, and I've always made it clear, it's not about me whatsoever. Not at all. It's about these players and team and just trying to have a year and get better. And they're enjoying themselves right now, but the crowd helped us. I mean, when they went crazy for a defensive play by Flagger to take a shot and get on the floor for loose balls, it's the most knowledgeable crowd in the country. And I thought it gave us a big, big lift in the last 5 minutes.
Jeff is going to have to go into the record books after the game with 21 of 22 from the free throw line.
Yeah.
It's
poise and getting the right guys fouled and having the ball in the right guys' hands late, Omega and Evan. But you know, it's huge, you know, and six turnovers. I mean, what do we have against New Mexico State, Jeff? Something like 20-something?